Okay, our next discussion is about the notion of period. So, let's start as usual. And I'll make this argument using sine again. So we know the basic graph of the sine curve. So here's 1, negative 1. There's pi. There's 2 pi. There's 3 pi, should we need it. And sine, here's pi over 2. 3 pi over 2. 5 pi over 2. 7 pi over 2. Here's the sine curve. So what do? We have the basic points. Remember, the basic points are really what guide us in drawing this graph here. And then we could do, for another period if we wanted to, the same basic points. 1, 0, negative 1. If it had space, there would be 0 again. Right? And we can do the same thing in this direction. Now, the next piece is, okay, so what happens if we change this function? Instead of multiplying by a value on the outside of the sine function, on the outside of this argument, what if we multiply something on the inside? So now what this means in the order of operations, remember, parenthesis happens first. So first, you double the number, and then you compute the sine of that number. All right? So let's plot a few points and see if we can figure what this looks like. Remember, what this means is first you double the x and then you do the computation. And I'm going to sort of guide you along since we're sort of working against the clock. If x is 0, this is straightforward. 2 times 0 is 0 and sine of 0 is 0. So this still passes through the origin. What I'm going to ask you, though, is to consider pi over 4. Because first you need to double this. Well, 2 times pi over 4, remember, it's top times top, bottom times bottom. This is sine of 2 over 1 times pi over 4, which is sine of 2 pi over 4. But what is 2 pi over 4? That's the same thing as sine of pi over 2. We know what sine of pi over 2 is. Sine of pi over 2 is 1. Sine of pi over 2 is 1. And so if pi over 4 is the original input, the first thing we do is double it to get pi over 2, and then take the sine of that value. If the input is pi over 4, the output is 1. This is a little different than before. Now, what if the input is pi over 2? Well, ordinarily, we would think sine of pi over 2 is 1, because sine of pi over 2, the function value, is 1. But what we must do first is double the number. So if you double pi over 2, this is sine of 2 times pi over 2. Well, 2 times pi over 2 is pi. This is sine of pi, and we know what sine of pi is. Sine of pi is 1. I'm sorry, sine of pi is 0. Sine of pi is 0. So, at x equals 0, the function value is 0. At x equals pi over 4, the function value is 1. At x equals pi over 2, the function value is 0 again. At x equals 3 pi over 4. Now, be careful. 3 pi over 4. The first thing we do is double. The first thing you do is double. What is 2 times 3 pi over 4? I'm going to go off to the side. 2 times 3 pi over 4. Well, the 2 cancels with the 4. This is 3 pi over 2. And I know what sine of 3 pi over 2 is. That's negative 1. And then, what is sine of pi? Notice we haven't got, all we've done, we've started at 0, pi over 4, pi over 2, 3 pi over 4, and pi. We've only gone through one half of a revolution of the basic unit circle so far. And we started at 0, got up to 1, back down to 0, down to negative 1, and now at pi, well, what do we do here? This is sine of 2 times pi. Well, we know what sine of 2 times pi is. Sine of 2 times pi is 0. And so I think if we plot this out, we can see what's happening now. I'm going to plot this in this blue. At zero, the function value is zero. But when does it achieve the maximum? It achieves maximum not at pi over 2. It achieves maximum at pi over 4. So that's where this thing peaks out. At pi over 2, we've gotten back to zero again. Do you see what's happening? At 3 pi over 4, the function value is negative 1 now. And at pi, the function value is 0. So, from 0 to pi, we've gone from 0 to 1 to negative 1. I'm sorry, 0 to 1 to 0 to negative 1 to 0. We've gone through all 5 basic points. We've gone through one complete cycle, and instead of taking all the way from 0 to 2 pi to go through one complete cycle, we've gone through one complete cycle between 0 and pi. Remember, the period is the minimum distance required to go through a complete cycle. In this case, the period is pi. So, it is half as much as what it was for the original function. The period for this function is 2 pi. The period for this function is pi. Do you see what happens? When you multiply this when you multiply this variable by 2, the period is halved. It's half as much. The rule is this. You take whatever the period is for the original function and you divide by that number. Whatever the period is for the original function, whatever the period is for the original function. That's why you need to know the periods for the original functions. Whatever the period is for the original function, you divide by this number. So sine of 2 pi, the period, is original function of original period of sine, divide by 2. The period of sine of 2x is pi. Similarly, if we had f of x, if we had sine of, let's say, 4x, what is the period? Well, of sine itself, it's 2 pi, but we divide by this coefficient on the inside. That simplifies to pi over 2. This curve would have to go through one complete cycle between 0 and pi over 2. Is it clear? That would be a very tightly squeezed curve. So the multiplier on the inside changes the period. Now, watch this. Suppose we have, and we'll leave you with this, suppose we have f of x is sine of 1/2 x. Can you see what's going to happen? Take the original 2 pi, but now you divide by 1/2. What does it mean to divide by 1/2? Well, to divide by 1/2 means you multiply by the reciprocal. So this requires 4 pi to go through one complete cycle. So the period for this function is 4 pi. So given any such function, you should be able to identify the amplitude, each of these graphs has amplitude 1, and you should be able to identify the period. The period is found by dividing by the coefficient inside the parenthesis. Take this period of the basic function and divide by the coefficient inside the parenthesis.